We're all looking for something. We're all looking for hope. Hope you can't just have just because you were born with hope. No, we're born with pain. We're born and live through difficulties. And in our life, we have a choice. Either to be angry for what we don't have or be thankful for what we do have.
It's your mindset that is going to allow you to spot opportunities where everyone else is frightened. Victims are frightened by change. Leaders are inspired by change. If your mind is full of worry, you're going to miss the opportunities because you're focusing on what's not working versus what is working.
It's your job to make yourself do the crap you don't want to do so you can be everything that you're supposed to be. And you're so damn busy waiting to feel like it. And you're never going to. You have to force yourself. And I mean force.
You must really go for your own and realize how short life is. You got what you got, so you got to make the most of it. You really can't spend a whole lot of time worrying about his. You really have to go for your own. If you have an idea of what you want to do in your future, you must go at it with almost monastic obsession, be it music, the ballet, or just a basic degree. You have to go at it single-mindedly.
Being brave isn't supposed to be easy. And for me, I feel it's the key way to keep moving forward.
Stop looking to others for approval. Go about doing things to improve yourself. Do whatever you can to improve yourself. Go make money for yourself. Go to the gym. Do whatever makes you feel good. Do it for your own reasons. But what I'd ask you to do is this. Go inside yourself, okay? Stop looking outside yourself, but actually go inside yourself and say, what do I really value? What is meaningful to me? What would I want to make out of my life? Not because I saw it in a fucking magazine, not because I had someone tell me that that was a value, but what would be a value to me? And if every day you're taking action towards that outcome, give yourself a pass to feel fully secure.
What would you do if failure was not on the table? Do you realize that 87% of people allow the fear of failure to outweigh their desire to succeed?